If you will, our first hymn for the day will be hymn number 187, In the Garden. We've done all these harpings, I can't sing. So you guys sing it out there.
Yes.
Let the water and the blood from thy wounded
Father, we thank you this morning for your love, your wise care, your mercy. And most of all, Lord, we thank you for your salvation. We pray, Father, for each one that's here. We thank you, Lord, for your presence. We ask you, Lord, to bless them in a special way for being in your house. We pray, Father, that as we go through this service and all that we do, might glorify the name of Jesus. Father, we pray for the many that are sick. We have several out of the ask you, Lord, to touch them. We pray, Lord, that you send your servant to them. We thank you, Lord, for the privilege we have for service. And we ask you, Lord, to bless our country, that we might continue to maintain that privilege of worship in America. We ask the Lord to bless the leaders of our country that they might seek your will and your guidance in the decisions that they make, and that they might lead our country in the direction that it needs to go. We pray, Father, for all of the military scattered around the world. We'd ask you, Lord, for their safety, that you keep us in peace. And we pray, Father, for the families of hope. We ask now, Lord, that you guide us as we continue this worship service, that all that we do glorify the name of Jesus. For we ask it in his name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Hey, John, happy to be here on this gorgeous Lord's Day. Say amen.
Amen.
Amen. It's going to be in the 90s today, and tomorrow evening sometime, they say it's supposed to rain. You remember that. And then off and on all next week, some scattered showers or maybe some good rain. So that's the weather report. So anyway, I want to welcome all our visitors. Don and Martha, it's good seeing y'all, and it's been a long time since, I guess maybe over a year since that nasty stuff started, and it's always good to see Joyce and Mark.
Amen.
And back there, Shannon, it's good seeing your husband here today, too. Everybody else is home, folks? Yes, but it's good seeing everyone. We had 8 in Sunday school. 8 or 9?
I got 8.
8, okay. 8 in Sunday school. So y'all come early. You have coffee, donuts, tacos. So that's, and it, well, Ken is our Sunday school teacher, but he's got the peonies today. So we really need to pray for Ken, you know, because his peonies are getting the best of him. And so, anyway, you know what next Sunday is? Yeah, hey, we get to eat next Sunday. It's the last Sunday of the month, and we get to eat. So, and we're going to have spaghetti and meatballs and salad and going there.
Yeah.
Good stuff. So, everybody is welcome. So, y'all come next Sunday and pig out on spaghetti. But anyway, that's what, and this is only the second time we've done this in a year's time because of the COVID stuff. So it's good getting back to the normalcy of the church. So we still have our board of concern. If you know someone who is ill, having problems for whatever reasons, we will put their name on the board and pray for them each and every day. So let's see. No, there's no service tonight, right?
No.
Okay, no service tonight. Wednesday night at 7 p.m. it's prayer service and Bible study. And so is anybody having a birthday getting any younger? I know Mr. Bill has a birthday next month in August. August the 22? No, probably. You'll have a birthday. And you'll be here and we'll sing to you. So, and okay, anybody having anniversaries? No. Okie dokie. Let's see. No. I did all that. I guess I did. All righty, that's all. Your turn. If you will, please turn your hymnals to page 407, Because He Lives. And if you will, stand on the third verse, that'll be our offertory. 407.
Thank you.
come before you, praising you, our Heavenly Father, thanking you for sending your Son, Jesus Christ, for our personal Savior. Because he lives, we have a future, Lord. We thank you for all the little things we take for granted, Lord. And I pray that each person here today would be grateful to you for all they have and all that you've given them, Lord. And I ask that you bless this offering. You bless those that give, Lord. For we know that we don't always do your will, Lord, but we pray that whatever we do with this money is according to what you have us to do. Dear Jesus, we ask that you be with all those that are sick. Would there be anyone here today, Lord, whether they be sick or they have a problem, we pray that you would help them with whatever their needs might be. We give you the praise and glory in the dear, sweet, precious name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Amen. If you find a wallet, just put it into a post office box and it will get mailed back to the people. I didn't know that. Some people do. Kathy said she knew that. I didn't know that.
I
So we had three people say, it'll get mailed back. So the third person was our mechanic of all people, because we looked at him and went, if you have to go in the RV, look, we were tired, because we said it, you know, we gave it to him for the maintenance, because we went 6,000 miles in a very short period of time. Anyway, he says, somebody, if they picked it up and threw it in the post office box, you'll have it back. Well, that day we got home, and it had been two and a half weeks. And we had this thing that said it was from the dead letter file, $4.95. We had a package we had to go pick up, and it was Mark's wallet.
Amen.
Let me tell you, I didn't realize how stressed I was until we got the wallet back. And I don't want to say stressed. I didn't realize how mad I was that he had lost his wallet until we got it back. And you know what? And it wasn't his fault.
Nope.
But this is the end of the story is, God is good. And we were telling people, I believe in a miracle-making God, and we got one. So whenever you're sitting around going, you know, he's a miracle-making God. Things happen. And things happen because he's wonderful. And he's taking care of us. Even with everything else going on. Right, Bill?
That's right.
Yeah.
There's 1,000 things going on in everybody's lives. People are terrified to get out in public. You know what? Don't be. You know, or if you are, that's okay too. Don't make anybody else feel bad because you're doing what you feel led to do. But make sure you're feeling led to do and not being bullied to do. Oh, sorry, Bill, I'll sing. I'll sit down and shut up. I don't have to. While on this road to glory that leads to my new home, many trials I have failed. But the lights of that city now lie before me. I'm near in the end of the race. I believe I'll walk a little farther.
but see.
Yeah.
done singing now, Mr. Bill.
Maybe he wants another one.
He's looking at him. Okay, you're going to have to talk to me. My psycho abilities aren't up to par today.
I think he wants another one.
Another one?
You have one.
The psycho's part of it.
That's enough, Lord. Mark said it was psycho. Which may be true, but... All right. Does anybody have a... Do you want to hear me sing a hymn? Do you want to... Bill? Oh, Bill's got one to do.
You ready, Bill?
If you're ready.
I'm about ready. Last week, I played a song by Henry Slaughter, a pianist, because we don't have a pianist here. And it was a big hit. So today, he's back by popular demand. And he's a top-notch pianist. We're talking way up there, much better than I am on anything. But I'm going to do this song with him, and it's called Gentle Shepherd. So I hope you enjoy it.
Need me. Yes.
That was three songs, I think that would be.
Okay, thank you. And now.
Now it's your turn.
Oh, I love when you play with me.
We're short-handed on our technical staff today, so I was having to run this on board. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good to see each one of you here this morning. I hope you have had a wonderful summer so far and looking forward to a lot more of it. It is great to see Joyce and Mark back with us for even a little while. They seem to be living on the road here lately. You see signs of them everywhere in the world, but here. So it's good to see you here. We always enjoy having them. Next Sunday is our second, last Sunday singing in over a year, I guess. And we're hoping that we'll have a lot of singers, and I know we're going to have a lot of food. So we urge you to come, bring somebody, bring your ears to listen and your voices to sing. And we normally start after the long-winded preacher gets through about 3 o'clock. I'd say that on a last Sunday that you'll find that the preacher quits his sermon pretty well on time because he's hungry too. So we will have our morning worship service, Sunday school and worship. We will have our lunch immediately following the morning worship service. Spaghetti and meatballs and all the fixings and whatever else you bring to go with it. Then in the afternoon, when we're too full to sing, we'll come over here about 1:30 and we will sing praises to the Lord until we get tired or run out of songs or run out of singers. So it'll be a glorious time. Joyce tells me they'll be in Houston, so we won't be able to hear them. I'm going to pick on them a little bit. I haven't been here in, what, over a year since you've been here for the last Sunday. Since it's been over a year since we met. Anyway, it's good to see each of you this morning. I'll try not to keep you too long. We welcome our ministers. I've got a duet over here that has promised to sing next Sunday. Young ladies said they weren't quite ready this morning, so. They promised they would be ready. That's not what I meant for. So, there it is. 1 Thessalonians. Get you a few verses here that get you primed in the 5th chapter. We want you to pay attention here because it really does apply to you. And as Christians, and most of you I feel are, not all of you, and there are some probably in the sound of our voice on the internet that will be listening that are not Christians, and so it's be a message for you also. And the 5th verse of the 5th chapter of 1 Thessalonians says, ye are all the children of light.
Amen.
And the children of the day. We are not of the night, nor of darkness. What do you think about that? What do you associate with darkness? All kinds of things go wrong in the darkness. We have all kinds of murders, robberies, crimes of every sort. Because those that are doing things wrong like to move in the dark. And so we should have no part of the darkness. We need to make sure that everything that we do is in the light. And the light that we need shining upon us all the time is the light of Christ. We need Jesus shining all over us and through us all the time, because then we will always be in the light. Even in the darkest of night, with Christ as the light, we are the light of the world. He tells us that we are to be a shining light in the world, that we are to shine upon the lost folks that they might see Jesus in us. That is our obligation to our Lord, is to shine our light bright enough that all of these lost folks out there, where there's a lot of them, might see Jesus in our lives, that we might live a life that shows that we have hope beyond the grave, that we have something to look forward to. You know, the world is without hope. They have nothing to look forward to. We're reading God here. So therefore, let us not sleep as do others, but let us watch and be sober. We need to be about our Father's business. We need to be not laying back in the shade somewhere asleep. We need to let that light that is in us shine on the world. Joyce has been going around the whole world here lately, shining her light, and I appreciate that, and I'm glad she shined a little on us this morning. And really, Bill shines his light here every Sunday when he's up here playing the piano and overcoming his infirmities to praise the Lord. That's what we have to do. You see, we all have infirmities. We can all find an excuse not to do something for the Lord because we hurt. If I didn't hurt, I'd figure I was dead. It's normal for us to hurt. Or I think it must be, because I hurt all the time somewhere. And so let it hurt. It doesn't keep me from going. Now there are times when it really slows me down. But as far as stopping me, no. And I don't tend to let my hurts stop me down. We need to let our light shine all the time. We need to be up and about our Father's business. We need to be showing the world that there is hope beyond the grave, that there's something to look forward to beyond the grave besides just a hole in the ground. This is what some people are looking forward to, are dreading and thinking is lies ahead of them, is just a hole in the ground and be covered up, forgotten, and that's it. You know, they say you only live once and you're dead and you're done. Well, that's not true. If you're a Christian, you live twice. You die once, but you'll live twice. Because I will live forever in the presence of Jesus because I have Him as my Savior. And if you're walking in the light of Jesus, you have that same hope within you. You don't worry about the grave, dead. Oh yeah, you are concerned. You know, you're not anxious to go right now. I've got a lot of things I'd like to do, but if I don't get them done, it doesn't matter. Kathy can work on them or somebody. Or they can remain undone. It won't really matter to me when I leave this world. I'm going to leave it once and forever. But I'm going to a place that is so much better that it defies my imagination to even guess what it's going to be like. I don't know what lies beyond the grave. I get a touch of it from God's Word, but actually it is a mystery. But I know that the Bible tells me very plainly that to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. So I know that I'm going to be there with Jesus when I leave this body. And we need that assurance so that we can go through this world with a happy face regardless of how we feel. We don't have to rejoice in the fact that we hurt. We rejoice in the fact that it doesn't matter if we hurt. We have Jesus. We have hope. We have something to look forward to. Oh, he says that, therefore let us not sleep as do others, but let us watch and be sober. For they that sleep, sleep in the night, and they that be drunken are drunken in the night. But let us, that's Christian, who are of the day, be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and for our helmet, the hope of salvation. I'm hoping in salvation because Christ has promised it to me. For God has not appointed us to wrath. Isn't that wonderful? God hasn't appointed us to wrath, but to obtain salvation by our Lord Jesus Christ. Salvation is what we have through Jesus Christ. If you don't have Christ, certainly you don't have salvation and you don't have any light in you. You're walking in darkness. You're separated from God and you're not one of His. But you don't have to remain that way. You see, Jesus died for whosoever would believe on His name and accept Him as Savior to live. If you're dead today in sin, you can be alive in a minute by believing Jesus and receiving Him as your Savior. Amen. You don't have to do anything fantastic. Fortunately, the plan of salvation is simple enough that even I understood it. It's simple enough for anybody. All we have to do is acknowledge that we're guilty before God. We're sinners. We're lost. We're on our way to hell. And then we decide we want to do something about it. You see, we have to do something about it. Christ will not force Himself into your life. He stands there knocking on the door, asking for an invitation. But unless you invite Him in, you'll never have Him in your life. But we believe that Jesus Christ died on the cross for our sins. We believe He paid the price for our transgressions on the cross. We believe that through Him we have eternal life because He's promised it. We believe that when Christ comes into our lives are changed. The old man is dead because of sin. He is forgotten, but we are alive today forevermore through Christ who lives within us. We are going to be with God forever in His heaven. It's not going to be a temporary thing. When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, and we've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first began. Time doesn't exist. Time doesn't matter. Time is of no importance. Isn't it going to be wonderful to live in a place where you don't have to keep watching the clock all the time? Yeah, I'm afraid I'm going to be late for work. I'm afraid I'm going to be late for my doctor's appointment. I'm afraid I'm going to be late for this, that, the other. I don't have to worry about that in heaven. If I'm 10,000 years late, that's all right. I'll still be on time. I'll have plenty of time because I have forever in heaven for everything. I like the song says, look for me after you've been there 10 million years, 10,000 years, a million or maybe more. Look for me because I'm going to be there too. Yeah. We won't have to look each other up immediately. Now, we can, I suppose, if we wish, but we don't have to hurry. No more hurry, no more rushing. What a wonderful place heaven must be. It says that they're going to see the river of life flowing from the throne of God. It says the tree of life blooming, bearing forth fruit in every season for food to eat. We won't have to work for our meals. We do another picks up off the tree and eat. What do you want today? It's going to be glorious, wonderful, and we're going to live there eternally. God is going to prepare a place for us. He's guaranteed that he will. And so we look at it, it says that we're not appointed to wrath. He doesn't want us to suffer the punishment that is reserved, actually, was intended for Satan and his angels. But if we refuse the plan of salvation because of the sin in the world and we allow it to rule in our lives, we are going to be there with Satan and his angels rather than in heaven with Jesus. So if we acknowledge that we are sinners, that we are not worthy of heaven, and we invite Jesus into our hearts and into our lives, he has promised that he will come into our lives and give us everlasting life. He says, my sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and no one can pluck them out of my hand. They are secure in the hands of Jesus forever. You are the light of the world. We have the light shining in us because Christ is the light. Let's let that shine, light shine from our lives to everyone we meet. We can have passion, have compassion on those that are lost because I was there once myself. I know what it was like. And I know what it's like to know that there is hope beyond the grave. I don't have to worry about tomorrow. It's already taken care of through Jesus Christ, my Lord. How about you? Are you in that condition? Have you got everything taken care of by giving it all to Jesus and accepting his salvation, his love, his forgiveness, his payment that he made on the cross for your sins? Have you done that? If you have, then you ought to be rejoicing in the light. You ought to be rejoicing. We were not appointed to wrath. God did not intend it for man to suffer this punishment. Man chose to sin. But God intended for us to have a home eternal with him in the heavens. And you can have that by accepting Jesus. You don't have to worry about death. If you have Jesus, you have life. Do you have Jesus? Do you know him as your Savior? If you've never invited him into your heart, if you're lost today, because without Jesus you're lost, you have no hope beyond the grave. You have nothing to look forward to. Why not accept Jesus? Why not try? He says, try me and prove me and see if I will fulfill all of the promises I have made. He doesn't ask us to take him and not prove it. He'll prove it himself day by day and hour by hour in your life if you're ready. Do you know that Jesus? Have you received him as your Savior? If you haven't, please let him in today. Don't wait another hour. Right now is the time of salvation. Right now is the time when you can have everlasting life through Christ by accepting him in your heart. Will you do that? Let us pray. Father, I thank you for the light that shines in darkness. And I thank you, Lord, that I saw that light in time. And I'm glad, Lord, that I have invited you into my heart and into my life to shine through me on others. and I pray that my light shines brightly, that others might see Jesus in me. I pray, Father, for these that are here today and those at the sound of my voice, that they might seek Christ's will in their lives, and that they might be saved on the way to heaven, and I'd be witnesses for them to a lost and dying world. Thy will be done in this invitation. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. We're going to stand together and we sing an invitation here. And I don't know what the Lord might be dealing with you all, the invitation is open for whatever need you have with the Lord. We invite you to come.
Please turn to hymn number 275.
Ask that they take you with them, keep you with them, and that all things are
shotgun, or you.